and also shot one of our 300 games this week.
And Carrie's an amateur. And Kathy, you rounded out that field. Good week for you. Top 24 to U.S. Open, always a good week.
You know, somebody had to come in last, and I said, you know what, I'll do it this week.
You weren't last. There were 243 people below you.
You're right.
Kelly Kulick will start off match number two against Wendy McPherson. A little bit high, leaving the 4-7.
That was a better executed shot, though. I just think 17 is breaking down. I spoke to Kelly after the tiebreaker, and she said she feels the lanes are going through that transition. The oil's carrying down, so it's forcing her to grab the ball a little bit, but she's not going to switch balls. She did that all week. She's going to stay with this ball and make it work.
She almost chopped that going at it. That's very unusual to see happen.
Yeah, the majority of the time you'll see people going cross lane to get the corner spares.
18 years on tour for this lady, 20 titles, and Kathy, that was a big goal of hers.
Wendy told us over a year ago her goal was to win 20 titles, and what better way to do it by winning the Queens for the third time.
Incredible. She's a lot more experienced than when she was 18, but going Brooklyn there, leaving a six pin. She said the 20 or more title winners is such an elite field, and just to give you a feel who that is, Lisa Wagner with 32, Alita Sill with 31, as Kathy were taking a look there.
Not a very good opening shot for Wendy, but like we said, it could be, I don't know about Wendy, but it's got, you have to have jitters. Wasn't a very good opening shot. She was lucky just to leave the six pin.
Spares it up. And as I was referencing, there's a look. I mentioned the top two, Leanne Barrett at 26, who you just saw on our show, Patty Costello, Tish Johnson tied at 25, and there's Wendy. So it is an elite group.
And our tournament leader, Carolyn, creeping up with 19.
She could join them.
I'm sure she's going to join them sometime soon.
I'm sure she is.
She qualified third, 223.12. That's a huge average, but great bowling this week by these ladies.
Oh, and a little high again. Broke out the 4-9, though. Leaves just a 9-pin. You know, Wendy was interesting talking about a live show. She said it's just so exciting to her.
It is. This was a much better shot, but it's got to be 17's drier than 18 because everyone has gone high on 17. She was lucky to catch the break by tripping out the 4-pin.
Well, not only would this be back-to-back majors if Wendy were to go on and win today, but she would win the Triple Crown for the second time, which is the U.S. Open, the Queens Tournament, and the old Samsung Invitational, which no longer exists, but Wendy won it twice and has the ability to become the second woman to be the two-time Triple Crown winner.
Unbelievable.
Second of any, I believe none of the men have a Triple Crown either, twice. Kelly Kulick now up in the second frame. Both bowlers working on spares. There's a strike, and as I told you, it's Kelly's third consecutive U.S. Open telecast, and she talked to us about why she bowls well in majors.
Well, usually the major events are longer formats. So I know there's so many games with three blocks or two blocks that if I have a bad block, I can come back and recover. So I definitely like the longer formats, especially with the U.S. Open. 56 games, you're not going to win it in one game. So if I have that bad game of 140, I know I can come back with 250. So definitely the longer formats are to my advantage.
And she's younger and can make it through the longer formats with greater ease than some of the more mature,
yes,
competitors.
Much better shot on the left lane. She obviously made an adjustment because she came up a little light and blew the pins. What a beautiful extension on this young lady. That's how she gets her ball to clear and recover with all that rotation, and she liked it.
Double.
That was the way we played the lanes this week, Jan. You constantly kept moving your line in to grab the oil. It wasn't so much to play the hook, it was to really play the oil. That's where your ball stores the energy.
So with that double, she has Kelly Kulick leads this lady, Wendy McPherson, by 11 pins. Wendy up in the third frame. Boy, she put some heat on that one. Threw that pretty hard.
Well, Wendy's always had a classic five-step delivery, pushes out on her second step. Perfect positioning right here, going into her slide. Nice slide, beautiful arm swing. But Wendy's biggest asset is when the lanes hook, she throws it harder. And a lot of girls can't keep their ball online as good when they have to throw it harder.
Exactly.
Wendy can.
Yes.
That's why she's so great.
Somehow she always comes up with the right ball roll to carry
as
well.
She does. Now remember, she's coming off wrist surgery.
Yes, and doing well.
She said she's never felt better. She had to drill up lighter balls to work her way back through her therapy. And she started to grab on a little bit. So Carol Giannotti worked with her. And when she got back to her regular weight ball of 15 pounds, she ironed the kinks out. Here she is.
Well, I'd say she ironed them pretty flat. No problem here, but she trails in this match. Still by 11 pins as Kelly Kulik now up in the fourth can take the lead to 21 with another strike. Kelly has put such tremendous pressure as she can go off the sheet if she strikes all the way out, that maximum score 290. Wendy McPherson maximum score 259, but Kelly has put such pressure on herself to win a title.
Yeah!
And with shots like that, she may, Kathy, but she went so far as to say to us, it was the ultimate obsession.
Ultimate obsession for this young lady.
Wow, Wendy McPherson record, TV appearances 104.
Leanne, 99, I'm sure she's gonna break 100. Carolyn, 73. I mean, that's a lot of TV time, and these ladies are averaging well over 210 for a TV average.
Yes.
That's a lot of games and a lot of good scores.
Kelly now in the fifth. She can take it to 31.
Yes! Great adjustment. Left lane.
She's pumped. Kelly Kulik is out in front through 4.5 frames. She's up by 31 pins. We'll return with the rest of this match after these messages. We're at the U.S. Open and are fortunate to have the Detroit Free Press High School Michigan Dream Teams. For the first time ever, they named a high school boys and high school girls dream team. They had a Miss High School Bowler, Katie Featherstone, and a Mr. High School Bowler, Daniel McClellan. And that's tremendous. And they came out to watch this event. They're looking, hopefully, forward to being a competitor in the future.
And that's where it all begins, with the youth. We have to keep the youth involved in order for professional bowling or bowling in general to continue. So all you kids out there, keep bowling in your YABA and watching the pros.
And watch our tournament leader. She's the high school
spokesperson for high school bowling,
yes.
Carolyn Doran Ballard. Yes, Kim Terrell is our collegiate spokesperson. Wendy defeated Kelly in match play.
Spares up that 10 pin, and Wendy right now just having some carry problems. A little bit high on lane 17 each time, not able to carry, and now leaving a 10 pin on lane 18. She trails by 32 pins at this moment.